Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel, that is UPSC. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the exam of civil services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So in this video we will be talking about our daily answer writing series, in which what we do, we daily give you a question of which you have to write the answer. So in this particular video we will be discussing the reference answer of that question which is given to you daily. So as students were demanding that, sir, please also start uploading the reference source for the questions you give. So we decided that we should do this so that you can get an idea about how to approach a particular answer, how to read a particular directive, and how to write a beautiful answer so that you can fetch those extra marks which are very important for your final selection. So today's question is, slowdown of Indian economy is an open secret now. In this context, what role can Keynesian theory play to arrest the downturn? Do you think government has that fiscal space available to implement it? So we have to discuss about it. So the word limit here is 250 and the maximum marks are 15. So friends, before starting, let me tell you that this is not a model answer. You are required to take it only as a reference source. So why we are saying this? Because no answer in UPSC can be model answer, because each and every answer has its plus points as well as negatives. So had that been the case, that is of model answer, the toppers would have scored 100% marks, but this is not the case as they score only 50 to 55% of the marks. So for that purpose we call our answers only reference sources. So let's start our discussion. So friends, the question is about slowdown of Indian economy. So it is an open secret now, so you have to tell that how this is an open secret now. So what are the signs that are there that are showing that there is slowdown in Indian economy? So in that context, then you have to analyze the role that the Keynesian theory can play to arrest this downturn. So for attempting this question, you must also know the Keynesian theory. So so also you have to tell that whether the government has that fiscal space available to it or not to implement this Keynesian theory. So let's start our discussion, friends. So sales of Maruti Suzuki, the largest car maker, and tractor sales for Mahindra have declined. So two-wheeler sales too started falling since December 2018. So there are signs of a consumption slowdown also. That are not just limited to now discretionary items, but they are spreading to non-discretionary items as well. Non-discretionary items are those items which you must buy for your survival. That is, you can't compromise on them. That is, for example, you can compromise on car or your scooter, but you will not be able to compromise on your food. So now the slowdown is to such extent that it has shown its impact on the non-discretionary items as well. So thus far it was feared to have impacted only discretionary expenditure, but now more data is coming in, so it is becoming clear that the Indian economy in general has been affected by it. So our macro indicators are not also very encouraging. So if we check the core sector, then this core sector growth was just 2.1% in July, as compared to the growth that was observed the last year. So this is very kind of, we can say, lax growth. So also because why it is also more concerning, because it contributes 40%, it together makes up 40% of the industrial production, and it is also used in other sectors as well as an input. So obviously if there is a decline in core sector growth, then obviously then manufacturing sector will show a kind of, we can say, contraction, and accordingly also obviously production will be low when there will be low demand. So in general the manufacturing sector has also been affected. So official data that has been released on Friday showed that the GDP in Asia's number three economy grew 5% in April-June, that is the first quarter of this financial year, from a year earlier, and the slowest pace since in 6 years. So this is clearly evident before you, and also this is the fifth straight quarter which has marked slowing growth rate. So it shows that there is a and it is also the longest slump since 2012. So there is weak manufacturing and consumption numbers. So country's GDP has reduced to a 25 quarter low, that is 4 year low, and sorry, 6 year low, and of 5%, and also then GDP growth rate has now slowed for the fifth consecutive quarter, with the previous low recorded 4.3% in March 2013. So sub 1% growth in manufacturing sector has been observed, and apart from manufacturing sector, agricultural sector is also struggling, and the slowdown has become evident by a kind of virtual collapse of consumption demand, evident from the tepid 3.1% growth in private final consumption expenditure. So since around October 2018, even the big corporates have been feeling the heat. Sales of everything are coming down. For example, cars, two-wheelers, trucks to consumer staples, they are all slowing down. So it could be a cumulative result of an extended investment famine, which together with demonetization, GST and agrarian distress and high real interest rates has taken a toll on incomes and spending. So these are the major signs, and already factors have also been highlighted there, that slowdown is kind of cumulative, and multiple factors are at play. So then demonetization has considerably reduced the growth, we can say growth story of India, including the haphazard implementation of GST. So now let's come to the second part of the question. So here we have been asked to analyze what is the role of Keynesian theory in this context. So friends, let's discuss what is Keynesian theory. So Keynesian theory is a theory that emerged out of First World War aftermath. That is in 1920s, when Great Depression was seen, the economy of the Europe almost collapsed, and there was no demand, and production sector or all the sectors were experiencing a kind of not favorable condition. So in that context, everything was becoming unproductive. So in that context, John Keynes, the economist, he came with the idea that in times of such low demand and so low aggregate demand and low growth, there must be focus by the government on the entire economy, and the government must invest, make investment to create favorable environment for the private sector to come in. So basically the purpose of Keynesian theory is to basically boost the aggregate demand by making investments by the government. So as the private sector sentiment may not be favorable to such an incentive, so it is expected from the government that it can step in and can make huge investments, hence upskilling growth. So now there is little doubt in India that we are on the downward slope of a business cycle. So obviously we are experiencing a low growth rate scenario. So Great Depression of 1930s, Great Depression of 1930s, it was felt that we have become capable of, or the world policy makers have become capable of dealing with the problem of depression, Great Depression, because of this theory of general theory of John Keynes. But then the basic cause of concept of this Keynesian theory is that downturn is basically lacked because of absence of aggregate effective demand, which can be a consequence of people's preference to hold on to money at a time of uncertainty. So it followed that there would be a fall in the rate of saving and investment. So this theory held that in this context, it is necessary that fiscal conservatism is not followed, because some deficit financing is required to give a push to the economy. So in short, it meant that there is a trade-off between inflation and full employment. That is, full employment cannot be possible by zero inflation. So Keynesian theory held that if you are targeting zero inflation, then you can't achieve employment and growth. So some inflation will be there. So this was the basic, these were some basic planks of this Keynesian theory. So in context of India also, the income uncertainty and desire to hold on to money was in all probability triggered by demonetization and later by initial hiccups of GST plan. So now the macroeconomic policy, as we have noticed in quite few years, it has been excessively focused upon controlling the inflation. In fact, the monetary policy goal is inflation targeting. So in that context, when the focus is on inflation targeting without the regard for employment scenario or growth scenario, what we have done is our monetary policy committee has achieved the target of controlling the inflation, but it has also seen the slowing down of growth and investment rates, and then consequent we can say a cycle, a vicious cycle. So India has does managed low levels of inflation, but then also it has also achieved targeted budget deficits, but the employment level and the growth story of different parts of India show that there is obviously a downturn. So all these things explain for the need of the Keynesian theory. That is, what will then this Keynesian theory will do? So government will be spending, and then investment will take place, and then demand will be created, and all activities will start operating. But then there are also some shortcomings with this Keynesian theory. Case against are the points like it may lead to stagflation, because if the government is financing, if the government is spending, then obviously that money will be in the hands of the people. So they will demand more and more things, and when they will demand more and more things, it will push it may push inflation to a high level. So it the problem of stagflation can also be encountered, that is your stagnation and your stagnant growth. And also government so a case against it is also that the government revenue is not increasing. If we see the GST revenue, it has in fact shown a trend that is not that satisfactory. So GST revenue is not coming in, so it may not but the now government's revenue from taxes is lacks in growth. So it may not have that much of amount to spend in the economy. So obviously when the GST collections are less, then how or the income to the government is less, then how it can invest in those sectors which can push demand. So fiscal, then there is fiscal deficit target of 3.3%. It may not be met if the idea is followed of your Keynesian theory. So then high fiscal deficit may further aggravate the problem of falling investment. That is, foreign investors may be dissuaded from investing and could also be downgrading the credit rating agencies. So what should be the conclusion? So friends, conclusion is simple. As of now, what we must do, we must adopt short-term as well as long-term measures. So what should be short-term measures? Short-term measures must be decreasing the interest rate and then promoting greater liquidity in the market, so the people can get money in their hands and the investor sentiment can be pushed up. And so this, in simple words, it is a time for Keynesian demand boost. So then there must also be prepared to make a measured increase in fiscal deficit year or two. So this will boost the demand for goods and be a much needed shot in the arm for India's firms and farms. So then other thing is when we say that building infrastructure, when this infrastructure is built, then it can boost demand and investment simultaneously. And in the long run, what we can do, skilling of the people, we can promote employment opportunities, we can bring in cyclic as well as structural reforms as was brought in 2016 in case of insolvency and bankruptcy court, all these things have been done so that the culture of permissionism can be minimized. So ultimately the aim should be to cut the culture of permissionism, because there are a lot of bureaucratic costs as of now. So there is a reason government allows this to persist, because obviously if citizens and business do not have to repeatedly turn to the government for permission, then this clips the government's power, and most governments have the tendency to resist it. So there must be as less permissionism as possible. So long run then only belongs to those nations who have a robust higher education, creativity and scientific temper. So these must be brought in. So among the developing nations, India was an outstanding performer on these sex scores. So advantage has been eroding in recent years. We must have the sagacity to reverse the trend. So friends, this is all about today's discussion about the model answer, or you can say reference answer. So if in case you are interested to join our daily mains answer writing initiative and can want to get the model answer for each question, then you can join our test series by using this link that is shown on your screen, and it will also be provided in the description box. So what are the benefits of joining? Daily one question will be given to you, and on every Sunday we will be taking your one full length test of 250 marks, and you will be given comprehensive evaluation of your answers and valuable feedback. So reference sources for all the questions will also be given to you, and also it is least costly. You can join on a monthly basis as well at a cost of just 1999 per month. So link is shown before your screen, and if in case you find it costly, then you can also join to our initiative that costs you just rupees 499. So this will ensure that you get daily targets. And but one point is to be noted here that the full length tests are not included in these daily questions. So you can if you are kind of subscribing for the initiative in 499, you are eligible for getting the questions in the weekday. So if in case you are interested to join, then do ensure that you check our description box and can check the payment link. So in case you're interested, then do ensure that you share this video, you like this video, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel. So thank you friends, have a very nice day ahead.